Are you down, did it down, did it down, did it down, down, down? Down, did it down, did it down, did it down, down, down. Are you down, did it down? Welcome to קומיוניקאסט, podcast about communities. Hi, Mali.
Hello, hi.
How are you?
I'm good, thank you.
It's great to be in Berlin. Thank you so much for coming.
Welcome to Berlin. I'm super happy to be here today.
Thank you. So I'm here with Mali Baum. She's a founding partner and CEO of W Lounge and a founding partner at Magda, which is a future funding fund. So Mali has 20 years of experience in running companies internationally, focused on products and e-commerce. She also founded the Busybee, which is a globally toy business. And she nominated for a Digital Female Leader Award 2017 by Women in Digital. She speaks at conferences. She's a mentor in many places. And basically, she's a leader of the female entrepreneurship here in Berlin, I would say.
Everyone define leadership in different way.
It's true. How do you define leadership?
I think leadership is more like influential things. And like for me, leadership, it's really connecting the right people and see them really succeeding because of this connection. So, as we took it in Berlin, as it's not only Berlin, actually, it's all over Germany or a bit Europe because we are super active there as well. It's really connecting between corporates, startup, technology, old industry, new industry, young generation, old generation, all of this, because we really need more support from the entrepreneurs, from the old generation into the new technology startups and so on that's happening here in Germany, in Berlin. And we all know that Berlin is hub of Europe, tech hub, mm-hmm. Germany. And everyone wants to call it like a Silicon Valley of Europe. Hope we will go there or we'll get there very soon. But it looks very promising.
You know, it's a podcast about communities. And when I first read about W Lounge, I was very intrigued to understand what kind of community that is, because you said earlier before we started, we don't have a Facebook group, for example. And it's very interesting. It's so different because now everything has Facebook groups, which also, I guess, makes this community more prestige or more exclusive. And maybe we should start with what is W and how it started, and then we can dive deeper to understand community.
First of all, let's talk about what we do have, but also like we are sitting in Facebook offices, so it's kind of like weird. But W Lounge started because I came from Tel Aviv with a lot of network and knowledge and experience. I worked a lot in China, and my main market was the U.S., so, yeah, we choose to live in Berlin, but we definitely came with a lot of things with us. And I saw that Berlin 5 years ago was so different, and really, like in business, we call it like a blue ocean, you know, like the sharks, let them fight. I'm building a new category here. And it was super interesting for me because, to be honest, the things that I built were like to really make Berlin my Tel Aviv. And you know what is Tel Aviv as an Israeli. You kind of like know everyone. You can approach almost anyone. And if not, you have friends of friends and so on. So I found that quite quickly that Berlin is much bigger and much interesting. And today, after 5 years, almost 5 years, I can say like I really made it a huge time Tel Aviv. Mm-hmm. And this is really a blue ocean, which means it's a bit behind, not a bit, like behind, in a lot of things. But as an Israeli, I came to Berlin and I learned a lot of things. I learned how to do things different way, different streaming.
Your culture.
new culture, you know, the family originally is also from Berlin. So we know that also from home, like my husband. Definitely when you are not running so fast, like us as an Israeli, we can do things much more, you know, strong and solid. And these are things that I've learned here. So they have a lot to learn from us, like go get there and do things that you plan. And we have a lot to learn from them in terms of like infrastructure and building something and not talk about like, okay, all will be good, but actually really make a great plan. So maybe I'm much more mature today. I think I am in business, and I'm never talking about things like you mentioned, Facebook group. And so like I'm not using the social media for the W launch, at least until now. Okay. Because we are growing super fast and we need
That's super interesting. How do you grow super fast without using the social media?
So as I mentioned, Berlin, like as a fact is bigger than Tel Aviv. So like in effect, there is much more people. So, when I started that, I started a different way. You know, I came to Berlin and I built, together with another partner, of course, we built up an organization that's called Women's Influencer, because I did a lot of things in New York, and New York was like the woman in tech, and it's called tech, entertainment and licensing, which was my industry then. And I've learned that if you have the right network, as an entrepreneur and also as an investor, you don't need to sell anything. And I've learned that through their network, because I was there with my small business, but actually the best customer came within this organization. So I wanted to tap in into the ecosystem, and I literally called those C-level women that runs, you know, things. You know, today they are my best friends, but then I didn't know anyone, literally anyone. And I started that with the Soul House, the first event. And we said like, okay, 30 women will come. And it was like more than 100. And
wow.
I said like, okay, there is a need. There is definitely a need. And it was super fast because, to be honest, I liked that a lot. We did a lot of things, but it wasn't a business. And, you know, you also need to grow up and say like, stop when you need to stop. And I stopped that, and then we built up the W launch. Of course, like I have an amazing partner, and I have like female partner, and I have like amazing team. Nothing that I'm doing alone or like take the credit to myself. It's amazing people surrounding us.
How many?
Like in the team right now, it's me and my amazing partner, Carolina. And we have an ambassadors, which is, we call them the door openers, but amazing people that are supporting us. And also we build like an IT force team, and we're built right now. We kick off in December. It's called Millennials by WLAN. So all of these so-called under forces, we call them. We have other people that lead that under our umbrella and structure and support and so on. So we have like 7 people today. And so how people came, you know, sometimes we're not going out there and say like, come to this and come to that. It was really friends bringing friends, because if you're happy with what you get, there is a value. So as I mentioned, when we did like a European Women in VC Summit in October, I mentioned like, literally, I didn't find a great event to network. So I just made them.
That's the best thing.
Exactly. So what do I need? I need really a great people to, you know, upgrade my business, you know, open doors for the right network, or if I need to target someone to sell my whatever. So I wanted the female founder, also founders, younger founders. It's open also for guys. Yeah, of course. But we will always keep ourselves promoting the woman by bringing them as a role model, speakers and so on. So people just bring people. You know, and so today I can say proudly that I don't think there's something stronger than W Launch in Germany in terms of community, or like really people feeling that they are coming for a great, valuable network.
What happened physically in your space?
There's no physical place.
Oh, okay.
There is absolutely amazing collaboration with Berlin Capital Club, with WeWork, with We Are All In. It's a co-working spaces. Bauma, which is a great corporate here in Germany. eBay, you know, I can...
Many partners.
Exactly. I can talk about that forever. But like, these are partners and they're all in our website because they're supporting us and we are supporting them. We are starting amazing collaboration with Porsche right now. And there's a lot of things that we can support those corporates, you know, bring them being very, very active, definitely like a scouting machine for technology or bringing the right people into their places. So what's happening there? It's super curated events because event, you know, it's actually how you bring people together.
Exactly.
We're doing a lot of things that tapping into a problem, like pain point, like how to raise money or like bring really the top people. We did, there is a word in Germany that's called Mittelstand, which is kind of like, how can I call it? In Israel, you cannot compare it because we don't have enough or like we don't have at all, but it's kind of like the big corporates that they're like middle, but very strong, very big. So we are working with a lot of them. So we are sometimes raising like all of them or five or six of them in a panel and talking about like how they can invest more into startups. So of course, startup will willing to be there because it's great access. And for them, they would die to know like great potential investments. So as you see, the focus is always about investments and knowledge and experience and so on. And also like a lot of VCs coming to us to collaborate with, you know, many topics. Right now we're speaking about like why there's not enough women investors. So as building a fund, we have to see more female investors. So we got a force with seven VCs all over Europe. It was in Berlin in Google. And we did like European Women in VC Summit in October. And we have like TechCrunch, we had Techstars, we had like all the huge name, the European Commission. Mm-hmm. Everyone came here, the VCs, and we had like 150 women. And wow. On purpose, 10% were guys because, you know, we cannot do any change or movement without the guys. Mm-hmm. Let's, you know, face it. But they were like a huge supporter. And it was amazing. And it did an amazing impact. And even like the European Commission, they came and said like, oh my God, we have to invest more. And we have to see more female investors. Because, you know, when female invest, sometimes they will invest differently, you know. And that we always said like the white man guys that always investing into white man guys. Or like it's kind of like everyone talking about that, which means they are investing probably in the same product and not touching other products that maybe can be the next unicorn, but they're not touching it. And also we can see a lot of female founder that's searching for investors and they cannot find it because maybe the product is too feminine or whatever.
I think that the amazing thing that I can definitely see here, that the community is absolutely physical because
absolutely
they meet all the time.
All the time.
And I have two questions coming up. First one is, how can people apply or be a part of the community? They should do something. They should pay for membership. They should pay per event or whatever.
First of all, no payment. This is my first rule. Because I don't want people to come because they can pay. I want the right people to be there. So, which means we need to have, to want to have you. So we're not that secret, you know, wlaunch.de. So you can sign in, you know, you can literally send us an email and so on. But most of the people coming, friends to friends, LinkedIn, approaching me, Mali, can I come? Can I join? Also to the team, not only to me. And if we're collaborating, for example, WeWork, so of course it's always open for WeWork community. I mean, this is my rule and this is the topic that we're bringing to the community on purpose. So it's not that complicated to join, but yes, we are more than several thousand people already that we know in person. Wow. Absolutely. It's kind of like really, you know, I would say a community. But we want always the you know, more, I would say, new people to come, because then it's much more interesting. Like I always say, like, oh my God, if there will be event that I don't know face, that's amazing for me. I love it. You know, sometimes I'm looking at the audience, it's like, you have to speak with this one, you have to speak with them, because they don't know how much they need each other. You know, this startup and this is M&A department, and magics can happen. So most of the event, I really know all of the faces, but it's 5 years, okay? So I'm more than happy to have more corporates, more people, more entrepreneurs. Definitely, I'm tapping into universities right now, working with Gizma Business School, and because they are doing an amazing MBA things and supporting female in crazy way. So if you can be a role model and teach them and bring education, absolutely, yes. And this is why we built a millennial, because a lot of corporate doesn't know how to speak with them. So it's kind of like community inside community, because I want them to get what they need. It's more educational. Like last time we did a kickoff with Gabby and Eve, they are running this, and they choose like self-defense.
You know? I love it.
We were like in the army, of course.
Krav Maga.
Exactly. But you know, for them, it was like, oh my God, oh my God. And I said like, and she said like, who from the audience ever did a Krav Maga, you know? And I was the only one. I'm sorry, I did army. But it was amazing to see how they reacted. And it's, you know, it's self-defense, and it's self-defense, you know, by meaning like how you pitch yourself. Mm-hmm. And the small thing, and they're super young. So these kind of things, you really make a big chance. So this is how they're coming.
And you know, my next question is, you cannot ignore that online communities became very popular. And also, I guess, when your community members want to stay in touch later or communicate in some kind of platform after the events, do you think about building something, or you have something in progress already?
It's a very good question, and actually we are dealing with it these days, because you know, Carolina, she's actually the head of, we call it head of innovation, and we were in Zurich, sorry, for like things, it's called like Rockstar Industries. It was amazing, and they teach us actually how to run a huge data, let's call it, a professional way. So she's the right person to speak about that. And yes, we are working also with our IT force in a tool that we know how to approach if we do highly selected or more closer group, like the dinners, we spoke about that, and things that are much more close group, to locate it from the crazy data that we have, because I'm so old fashioned, like Excel is working super hard on my computer. And I love it, actually, but I need to learn a new tools. So about the online, I'm not going to be an online tool of copying other content to bring it in. This is not me. Mm-hmm. So we are working right now on building W Launch magazine. It's not because we're going to be a magazine. It's because we are speaking amazing things and
sharing
doing a lot of
knowledge,
change inside those events. And I think we're on the right time to share it exactly with broader audience.
Amazing. Can you tell more about who are the community members?
Yes, absolutely. I would love to. First of all, as I told you, we have an ambassadors, and they are people that they are really high level and influence, and they are not only from Berlin, also from New York, also from other cities, and we love them. And actually, it's people that we love to work with. So we always said, like, you know, we really want you to be an ambassador, or they're asking to be an ambassador, because they're tapping into the community. So it's a win-win. What they need, we also support them. They also have like companies, head of whatever, politicians and so on. So I also, as a person, believe that everyone needs a mentor. So one of them is really my closest mentor, and I really asking her like a very big question in terms of culture and so. And the community itself, it's everything. You know,
yeah, we are working. It sounds so diverse.
And you know, it's kind of like whom we are doing business with become part of the community. So it's, again, corporates, you know, all the name dropping that I can do, it doesn't matter, but like it's corporate. So it's CEOs, it's M&A department, mainly the investment force, it's the innovation force, Sometimes the HR, because we are running amazing program HR right now, 12 HR all over Germany. And I like it because it's going to be a big change right now, like how people hiring people and how people really want to not be hired anymore, like kind of like freelance to keep the flexibility, but still like have, you know, the salary. Mm-hmm. So we are tapping into that. And so it's a lot of
and
startups.
And young entrepreneurs.
Exactly. So it's universities, M&A departments, so MBA students. And it's definitely tons of startup, seed round, growth, and huge startups from all over the world. Absolutely, the concept is, you know, that the focus is Germany. This is our headquarter, let's call the hub, Berlin. Mm-hmm. And we wanted to be very proud of out of Berlin. So it's a co-working spaces, as I mentioned, because they are the ecosystem as well. So we support them in kind of like how to become a community or really bring content into it. And it's government support, it's venture capital. We're working with Berlin Partner like very, very closely. Berlin Partner, it's kind of like the digital hand of the Bundestag, Berlin Senat as well. To do a lot of things, like I'm part of things that called Start Alliance. We bring startup to Berlin for 2 weeks, every time different topic. The last one was November healthcare, and for 2 weeks everything covered by the government, and show them all the ecosystem, investors, knowledge, and so on. It's amazing program. Wow. So I'm part of it, and the you know, it's kind of like, you know, all the layers are inside, which means if you are part of the community, you probably have the access. But yes, it's not a group, but you can ask for connection. And I think no one asked and never got, you know, an introduction and so, because this is us.
Yeah, I can really feel it.
Yeah, okay, that's good.
Do you find the women community is different?
You know, as much as we will have more women communities, I will be more happy. You know, there's no competition. It's only gather force, and I'm doing it, definitely. But it's much more social. And I don't want to see W Lunch as a social. Of course it's social, you know, it's event, mm-hmm. right, food, blah, blah, blah. But it's much more business mind focused, and emails that I'm getting afterwards, like the one that I told you, that every mm-hmm. time I'm coming to an event, I kind of like upgrade my business. This is exactly the reason we are running W Lunch. So women organization, absolutely we are. Our USP is a woman support. We are supporting diversity in general because, you know, it just makes the business better. It's not us, it's the research mm-hmm. showing it. And we need that more in Germany, because if we speak about Tel Aviv or New York or Silicon Valley, it's worse in Germany. We need much more women into influence position and more female founder and to support them. So the majority of the speakers usually are women. So I would say we are also a woman organization, but the men are more than welcome, because together we can do a change.
I like this attitude. Yeah. What is your main challenge at the moment?
In W Lounge mm-hmm. or in general? The challenge is to grow smartly, because we are growing very fast, and grow fast is also a challenge. And to grow smart, to build the right team, to get the right people inside. And because we are raising the fund, we will always be part of W Lounge. But I know that in some point, the investment fund will take the focus. There will be another value for W Lounge. And, you know, it's a great combination, let's say, because today no one is coming for the money as an investor. They're coming also for the added value, and the network is huge value. Also from our investors, potential LPs, they see the network, and this is a huge value for them, because they will own it once they will invest in it. And I think that's the challenge, you know, to find the right direction. There's tons of opportunities, but I hope that we will choose the right one.
Yeah. Yes. Okay, this is the last question.
Okay.
And which I always ask at the end.
And not about Tel Aviv? Okay.
Not about. Do you want to talk about Tel Aviv?
That's okay.
So the question is, if tomorrow you'll have all the time and money in the world,
okay,
which community you would like to create?
Ooh. I would like to create... Okay, this is a big one. I'm going to create, okay?
Oh, I like it already.
a community that will be not that big, but definitely super international for female influencer, which means politicians, decision takers, investors, and all of this that we can really shape, I would say, the ecosystem, but gather force big time, Tel Aviv, Berlin, Silicon Valley, New York, Shanghai, all these markets. I know very well women there, and we can, I mean, we will build that in some point. We are just, you know, each one of us growing, and at the right moment, it will gather force. That's my dream, yes.
Great. I can see that you're already going there.
So. I have a plan.
I'm not worried. wow, Mali, thank you so much.
Thank you for coming all over to Berlin.
it was a pleasure to host you at Communicast, and I'm sure our listeners got a lot of value. I will also put a link to W Lounge, to your profile. Mm-hmm. I must say that you're so nice and super welcoming. So I guess people will listen and want to contact you.
Thank you. They're more than welcome to contact me.
Yeah, exactly. Thank you for listening. Thank you for Facebook Berlin for hosting us. And see you next time.
Absolutely.
Thank Bye. You. Down, are you 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 down, are